2013 was in many ways a dream season for Kingston FC. After a disappointing expansion season the year previous, the squad ran roughshod over the Canadian Soccer League. With a high-octane attack and solid defensive structure, Kingston captured the regular season championship in just their second year.
I think everything sort of came together in more ways than we could have really ever anticipated. You know, after the first season the team had, it wasn't, you know, obviously it wasn't where anyone wanted the club to be. You know, some would say we'd hit rock bottom, I suppose. They brought in, you know, myself, Catlin, Jason Massey, a lot of guys that really played massive roles in our club doing well last season. And I think as a group of 18 players, we just really bought into the system, and we all played our role to the point where, you know, we couldn't have really done much better. And I think it showed with the result, I suppose, at the end of the year.
Kingston seemed poised to make it a double, both the regular season and playoff championships. Heavily favored heading into the final, they ran into a veteran Waterloo squad that was peaking at just the right time. And the dream became a nightmare as Waterloo ran away with a convincing 3-1 victory. It was a tough pill to swallow for a team that had been so dominant all season.
Yeah, it was very, very tough, but we know in our hearts, we did not play that day. We did not perform anywhere near our capabilities. It was a massive disappointment to us, but we were not scratching our heads wondering why. We knew why.
We probably missed experience. Some players, it was the first final. So, I don't know, we were really close. Like, won the season, the championship was a big thing for us, and like maybe after, like, we drop a little bit, I don't know. But yeah, we're gonna have another chance this season.
This season, the goal remains the same, regular season and playoff champions. And with much of their core returning from 2013, the team has the tools in place for another strong run. Last year, Kingston scored 69 goals, 22 better than the next highest team. So needless to say, offense is not a problem. They boast the CSL's most dangerous weapon, reigning league goal-scoring champion and MVP, Guillaume Serreau, who racked up 28 goals in 22 games.
He is he's the best striker I think I can safely say that I've ever played alongside. He brings so much more than just goals. Obviously, those are the things that people notice. You know, you're not going to score 30 goals in the CSL and not, you know, be known for his goal-scoring ability. What he does off the ball, what he does in build-up play for the team is massive. It's really important. You know, for myself as a center back, one of my outlets is always Guy. He's always on. He always wants the ball. He's demanding of each other, of his teammates. And, you know, sort of in the same vein as Colm, he really does expect the best out of everybody, and that's something that you can only appreciate in a player, especially a guy that plays up front with as much confidence as he does.
The big Frenchman feeds off the remarkable playmaking skills of midfielder Edgar Soglo, now in his third season with Kingston after a previous stint with Capital City FC.
Edgar brings wits, provides us somewhere to go when we're going sideways. He brings skill, individual ability to beat a player. He brings speed, his quickness off the mark. He brings composure. He can finish when he's asked. And he brings great spirit, and he's a top player in my eyes.
Romanian Catalin Licheoiu is another part of Kingston's devastating offensive arsenal. Deadly from any distance, he's a free kick specialist who's left the opposition shaking their heads many times.
For me, it's like he's the better player with like I play like in my life. Like he's really smart. Like he understands, the game. Like I never see people understand a game like this. Like it's really easy to play with a guy like this. He play one touch, make the run behind me, give good balls. Like it's really amazing.
On the back end, Joe Zuppo and Ryan McCurdy anchor a defense core that allowed just 30 goals last season. Zuppo doesn't hesitate to extol the virtues of McCurdy's play.
Hey, my center back partner, he's a great guy to be around. He's phenomenal with the group in and out of the locker room. You know, he lightens the mood. He's a great character to be around, and above all else, he's a phenomenal player. Very strong, very, very dependable center back, and somebody that I feel very, you know, comfortable playing next to, especially in such a position that's as critical as center back is to this game.
Reigning CSL Coach of the Year Colm Muldoon's squad is talented and disciplined. And after last season's championship disappointment, they're hungry to finally take that last step to greatness.
It's motivational to know that we got so close and then just to fall short. You know, sky's the limit, to be quite honest with you. I think this team has all the capabilities and all the potential to do phenomenal things, and I really do hope in both divisions now that we can win the double and really, you know, make Kingston proud of the team we've sort of assembled.